Siang pemirsa, senang sekali saya Sri Rahayu Putri kembali hadir di layar kaca Anda. Di mana lagi kalau bukan di acara kesayangan kita, Forum Edukasi Bahasaku, Belajar Bahasa Inggris TVRI Bengkulu. So how's life going everyone? Apa kabar hari ini? I hope that all of you are doing great and keep doing great things in life. Semoga pemirsa yang ada di rumah senantiasa dalam keadaan sehat walafiat dan juga dalam lindungan Tuhan Yang Maha Esa. Alright, and just like usual ya, selama satu jam ke depan, saya Sri Rahayu Putri dan seluruh kru yang bertugas akan menemani Anda untuk belajar bahasa Inggris dengan tema yang menarik dan tentunya edukatif. Alright, so can you guess what is our topic or theme for today? Yep, I will give you a clue. This is gonna be very interesting and very specific. So what are you waiting for? Yeah, just like usual also, please grab your pencil, grab your pen and book if you feel like, oh, it is necessary for me to write it down. Or you can just type it on your gadget or remember it. Jadi silakan kalau misalnya mau dicatat ya adik-adik ataupun mau diketik di gawainya atau kalau misalnya mau diingat aja silakan. But I hope that you won't forget about our theme for today so we could continue to the next topic. Jadi kita bisa lanjut ke topik selanjutnya. Okay. Now we are moving to the first one. Okay, the theme for today is about birds and bugs. Jadi kita akan mempelajari mengenai, you know, vocabularies of kind of birds as well as bugs di dalam bahasa Inggris. Kita akan mempelajari kosakata terkait dengan nama-nama burung dan juga nama-nama serangga yang ada di dalam bahasa Inggris. So, without further explanation, let's jump to the first one. This is the first one. I bet that all of you pasti pernah melihat hewan ini. Meskipun hewan ini sangat tiny ataupun kecil ya. Okay, but it could be dangerous. Kalau misalnya this animal, this bugs bite you. Okay, so this one. What is the name of this creature? Ada yang bisa menebak? Okay, pay attention to this carefully. Pay attention to this carefully. And then, can you guess what is the name of this insect ataupun bugs? Yep, benar sekali. We call this as ant. Alright, that's how you pronounce it. Ant. Yep, very nice. The way you pronounce it as ant and the way you spell it as A-N-T. Yep, I will give you clue what is it or what does it mean in Bahasa. So this is an animal or a bug that really likes sweet things. Yang sangat menyukai hal-hal manis ya. Dan biasanya mereka ini bergerombol. Okay, atau berkelompok. Kira-kira what does it mean? Benar sekali adik-adik yang ada di rumah. Ini artinya adalah semut. Okay, nah kali ini Kak Sri juga akan mengajarkan kalian. Oke, bagaimana cara mengungkapkan kalau misalnya kalian itu takut terhadap hewan ini? Oke, you could say this. I am afraid of ant. I am afraid of ant. Artinya saya takut dengan semut seperti itu. Afraid of ya, kalau afraid itu pasangannya of. I am afraid of ant. That's it. Oke, very nice. This is for the first one. Now we are moving to the next bug. Can you guess? Kira-kira kita akan mempelajari apa? Yang selanjutnya. Alright, still with our topic. But this is the next one. This thing. What is the name of this creature? In English. Yep. I will give you clue. It starts with F. Jadi huruf awalnya ini adalah huruf F. Ya, ada yang kira-kira bisa menebak? Right, benar sekali. So this one is fly, okay? This one yang kecil ini artinya adalah lalat ya, fly, okay? So fly itu bisa berarti berbagai hal adik-adik. Kalau kita membicarakan mengenai atau if you are talking about kata kerja, maka fly ini artinya terbang. Tapi kalau kita berbicara mengenai serangga, berarti fly ini adalah lalat. Okay, now how to say if you are takut dengan lalat. Yap, benar sekali. I am afraid of fly. I am afraid of fly. Artinya adalah saya takut dengan lalat. Atau kalau misalnya tidak takut, you can just add not. I am not afraid of fly. I am not afraid of fly. That's it. Okay, very nice. So it's gonna be F L Y. That's how you spell it. Okay, now can you spell it together with me faster? F L Y. Very great. And you already know how to bagaimana cara mengungkapkan ketakutan atau kalau misalnya tidak takut terhadap serangga ini. Okay, now can we move to the next one? Here we go. Alright, okay. What is the name of this thing? This creature, yeah? Can you guess it? From the gestures as well as from the color or, you know, like the thing that this bug do? Iya, benar sekali. This one is caterpillar. Okay, please repeat after me and we are going to say this slowly. The way you say this thing is caterpillar. 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 So it's as if there's four suku kata ya. Caterpillar. That's it. Okay, so what does it mean by caterpillar here? Okay, ada yang tahu? Adik-adik yang ada di rumah? Yeah, congratulations. Benar sekali. Jawabannya adalah ulat. Ya, ulat bukan ular. Caterpillar means ulat. Okay, so how if you are takut dengan ulat? How to say this? Yep, benar sekali. Bisa dengan I am afraid of caterpillar. Caterpillar. I am afraid of caterpillar. Artinya saya takut dengan ulat. Atau kalau misalnya kalian tidak takut, cara mengungkapkannya adalah dengan I am not afraid of caterpillar. That's it. Caterpillar. That's how you pronounce it. Now, let's spell it together. It's gonna be C-A-T-E-R-P-I-L-L-A-R. Very great. One more time. It's gonna be C-A-T-E-R-P-I-L-L-I. Okay, I'm sorry. A-R. Very nice. Okay, now the next one. So, from caterpillar, caterpillar actually could, you know, metamorphosis menjadi this one. Okay, this one, of course, yeah, this is also one of the things that we should learn today. Okay, from the caterpillar change into the, alright, benar sekali. Butterfly, okay, butterfly. Butterfly here means, yep, can you see carefully to this picture, bisa dilihat secara seksama gambarnya adik-adik, kira-kira artinya apa kalau misalnya di dalam bahasa Indonesia? Benar sekali, artinya adalah kupu-kupu. Exactly, so from the caterpillar, dari ulat itu bisa menjadi butterfly, okay, ataupun kupu-kupu. Benar sekali, the way you pronounce this as butterfly. Yep. And the way you spell it is B-U-T-T-E-R-F-L-Y. Okay, it's kind of tricky how to spell it. Now, let's, you know, repeat it one more time. It's gonna be B-U-T-T-E-R-F-L-Y. Butterfly. That's a butterfly. Okay, butterfly is very beautiful. Itu juga bisa contohnya ya. Jadi butterfly is very beautiful. Now, how to say that? Probably kalau misalnya kalian takut dengan butterfly. Benar sekali. I am afraid of butterfly. I am afraid of butterfly. Atau I'm not afraid of butterfly. I am not afraid of butterfly. Because butterfly is very beautiful. Butterfly has so many colors. Colorful. So I like butterfly. I'm not afraid of butterfly. Bisa juga seperti itu ya, kalau misalnya contohnya lebih panjang. Jadi saya tidak takut dengan kupu-kupu. Karena kupu-kupu itu memiliki banyak warna dan juga sangat cantik. Makanya saya jadinya tidak takut, melainkan suka dengan kupu-kupu seperti itu. Baik, mengerti adik-adik sejauh ini? Okay, alright. If you already understand, it's time for us to move to the next one. We're still talking about bugs, ya. Kita masih berbicara mengenai serangga. This is also one of, you know, kind of bugs here. The one that has web ataupun memiliki jaringan, tapi bukan jaringan internet ya. This is the real jaringan, okay? Okay, jaring-jaring, okay. That's it actually. This one we call this as, you know, spider. Yes, spider. So spider itu masih belongs to bugs ya, bukan kategori birds. Okay, so bugs. Spider is a bug. Ataupun seekor serangga. Now, let's learn together with me how to pronounce spider carefully. Spider. Spider. So not speeder, but spider. So it's the same, okay? Like a one hero, probably like Spider-Man, not Spider-Man, but Spider-Man, because it's in English. So if you are afraid dengan spider, you could express it with, I am afraid of spider. Artinya adalah saya takut dengan laba-laba. Benar sekali. So spider here means laba-laba. Okay, got it? Very nice, very clever. How if you are not afraid of spider? How to express it? Exactly, you could just say, I am not afraid of spider, but I'm afraid of caterpillar. Bisa juga kalau misalnya digabung seperti itu ya adik-adik. Jadi saya tidak takut dengan laba-laba, tapi saya takut dengan, okay, misalnya ulat. Okay, because it's kind of, you know, make me a little bit feeling like tingling or something like that. That also could be another example. Get it? So actually there are many ya, banyak sekali, you know, kind of bugs that we are going to learn today. But several of them we are going to learn today. Hopefully it could cover everything. Now this one. This is one of, you know, the bugs that probably people hate the most, as it brings many, you know, unnecessary things in our life, just like a sickness or something like that. Okay, ini biasanya menghisap darah pada manusia. Can you guess what is the name of this thing? Okay, the name of this bug. Nama dari serangga ini. So, what is the name of this? Exactly, the name of this bug is mosquito. Mosquito. Alright, that's how you pronounce it. One more time, the way you pronounce it is mosquito. Okay, it's going to be M-O-S-Q-U-I-T-O. Mosquito. That is a mosquito. I am afraid of mosquito. Okay, because it sucks our blood. Atau itu, dia menghisap darah kita. Alright, and it brings many harmful things for the human. Ya, jadi dia ini juga membawa ketidakbaikan. Okay, untuk manusia, something like that. Salah satunya dia bisa menjadi penyebab demam berdarah and also malaria ya. So please be careful of this bug ya, jadi, or insect. So be careful of this creature ya, harus hati-hati dengan mosquito. Please be careful of mosquito. Okay, I am afraid of mosquito. Okay, that's if you are afraid of. But if you like to warn people, you could say, please be careful. There are many mosquitoes here. Okay, so you could use like lotion to protect yourself or something like that. All right, now the next one. This is also one of, if I could say, this is also one of the bugs that people probably hate the most. Alright, because it lives, okay, yang setelah ini ya, it lives, okay, you know, in the dirty area, something like that. And it's dangerous for our health as well. Yeah, what is the name of this thing? Alright, the colors is brown, and you know, it lives in dirty area or the area there is not so clean. So what is the name of this creature? Exactly. This one is cockroach. All right. The way you pronounce this as cockroach. Very great. So cockroach here. What does it mean by cockroach here? Pemirsa yang ada di rumah tahu? Atau mungkin adik-adik bisa menjawab? Alright, if you already looking at this picture, what comes on your mind? Yep, benar sekali. So, the answer is kecoa, ya. Okay, in Indonesia, in bahasa Indonesia, we call this as kecoa. But, in English, we call this creature or this thing, ya. Not this thing, but this bug as cockroach. Okay, now please repeat after me one more time. It's cockroach. Alright, we are going to learn many more bugs as well as birds. But before that, kita akan saksikan dulu jeda pariwara. Don't go anywhere. Stay tuned on TVRI Bengkulu.
Satu dari empat gendang besar di dunia. Gendang besar tanpa resonator. Alat musik, tradisi, dan kreasi. Bicara alat musik Bengkulu, bicara dol, tradisi, kearifan, bicara dol, bicara Bengkulu.
Guna mendukung migrasi siaran TV analog ke digital, TVRI akan memulai tahapan analog switch off di 11 kota dan Batam. Dan akan dilanjutkan secara nasional mulai 2 November 2022. Siaran TVRI sudah dapat ditonton melalui TV digital. Terdiri dari 4 kanal digital. Kanal 1 TVRI Nasional, Kanal 2 TVRI Daerah, Kanal 3 Budaya, dan Kanal 4 Olahraga. Siaran TV digital dapat dinikmati dari televisi yang telah dilengkapi perangkat digital atau dengan televisi lama menggunakan set-top box. Siaran TV digital memberikan kualitas gambar yang bersih, suara jernih, dan beragam konten secara gratis. Yuk beralih ke digital. TV digital bersih, jernih, canggih.
Woi, di sana segalanya.
Nggak usah lah ngasih sampah do.
Lah tugas pemerintah kita membersihkan sampah do.
Woi sana, sampah di situ udah banyak. Kalau bukan kita, siapa lagi? Iya dek.
Betul tuh dem.
Hei, dan lah.
Woi sana, kita nengok pengumuman tuh. Mato tuh dipakai. Mato. Weh sana. Kalau bukan kita, siapa lagi yang nak bersihkan sampah ko?
Pemirsa masih dalam acara kesayangan kita, Forum Edukasi Bahasaku, Belajar Bahasa Inggris TVRI Bengkulu. So for those who just joined us, our topic for today is about birds and bugs. So yes, we already talking about several bugs. Now we are moving on to the next one before we move to the next categories as well. Here we go again, without further explanation, let's just see this. Okay, so we already talking about this cockroach before. Now I'm going to tell you how to express kalau misalnya kalian itu takut dengan serangga ini. Okay, you could just say, I am afraid of cockroach. I am afraid of cockroach. That's it ya adik-adik. Kalau misalnya yang takut itu adalah kakak laki-lakinya, yes, you could just say, my brother is afraid of cockroach. That's it. Okay, get it? Very nice. If you got it, we are moving on to the next one. Alright, pay attention to this picture carefully. What comes on your mind whenever you see this? Kira-kira apa yang ada di benak adik-adik dan juga pemirsa yang ada di rumah ketika melihat this picture ya? This is a cartoon version. It doesn't only have, you know, green color. It has many color as well. Okay, but okay, this one we call this in English as grasshopper. Ya, benar sekali. Jadi kalau misalnya di dalam bahasa Inggris kita menyebutnya dengan istilah grasshopper, grasshopper, atau kalau misalnya di dalam bahasa Indonesia dikenal dengan nama belalang. Iya, benar sekali ya. Biasanya belalang ini berada di rerumputan atau dedaunan, something like that. And of course, it could jump very highly ya. It could jump, okay. Ini bisa meloncat ya, dan loncatannya itu biasanya sangat tinggi. Okay, but tidak semua orang itu tidak takut dengan belalang, okay. Even though it doesn't have like a sting or something like that, people also could be afraid of. Okay, people also could be afraid of this, you know, bug. So if you're afraid, you could just say, I am afraid of grasshopper. I'm afraid of grasshopper. Or I'm not afraid of grasshopper. I find they are very cute. Jadi saya tidak takut dengan belalang. Saya malah mikirnya, okay, kalau saya berpikiran bahwa belalang itu lucu, bisa juga seperti itu. Okay, that's the example. But I will remind you one more time. Ayo adik-adik kita belajar cara pronounce-nya bersama-sama. Benar sekali, grasshopper. That's it. Okay, now let's learn how to spell it together. It's gonna be G R A S and then like H O P P. Okay, I'm sorry, P P E R. Okay, grasshopper. It's like a P P E R. Yes, grasshopper. Very great. Now we are moving to the next one. Okay, so yes, this is also belongs to bug categories atau insects ya. Jadi dia ini termasuk kategori bugs ya, yaitu serangga. And dia ini memiliki sengat ya, jadi hati-hati kalau misalnya berada di dekat serangga ini. Okay, apalagi kalau kita nggak sengaja nih mengganggu sarangnya, itu biasanya okay, langsung akan menyengat kita. Alright. But this also, this animal or this bug itu juga menghasilkan sesuatu yang memiliki manfaat yang sangat banyak untuk kesehatan kita, yaitu honey ataupun madu. Nah, kira-kira what is the name of this animal or this bug ya, ataupun serangga ini? Ayo, adik-adik yang ada di rumah bisa menebak? Okay, there you go. Benar sekali. So congratulations for those who answer with B. Iya, benar. Jadi bukan B ya, tapi the way you pronounce this as B. And the way you spell it as B-E-E. Okay, B-E-E. But the way you pronounce it, one more time, it's B. Okay. Nah, kalau misalnya adik-adik yang ada di rumah takut nih dengan hewan ini, bagaimana cara mengungkapkannya? Iya, benar sekali. You could just say, I am afraid of bee. I am afraid of bee. Atau bisa juga seperti ini. I am not afraid of bee, but my mother is. Artinya adalah my mother is afraid of bee. Okay, saya tidak takut dengan lebah, tetapi ibu saya yang takut. Kira-kira seperti itu pemirsa. Okay, so does anyone di sini berani dengan bee? Okay, brave enough to get close to the bee. Okay, but please be careful yeah, if you like to, you know, see this. Maybe if you need to do some experiment with this you know, serangga ataupun if you like to take the honey from the bee itself, you gotta be careful ya, karena kalau tidak berhati-hati bisa saja kita disengat, okay, and it will make your face probably atau areanya itu bloated ya, bengkak biasanya, and of course you will feel the pain ya, so be careful, maintain your, you know, social distancing with the bee. This one, okay, this is also still belongs to bugs kategori ya, jadi dia ini juga termasuk ke dalam kategori serangga. Okay, right, of course ya, ini memiliki sayap ataupun wings, but again, it still belongs to bugs and not birds. Kira-kira, what is it? Mm-hmm. What is the name of this thing or this creature, this bug? Mm-hmm. Yep, it start with D ya, jadi huruf awalnya itu adalah huruf D. Mm-hmm. Can you guess it? Alright, there you go again. This is dragonfly. Alright, the way you pronounce it is dragonfly. Nah, pemirsa, untuk you know, penulisannya itu digabung. Karena kalau misalnya dipisah, itu artinya akan lain. Kalau misalnya dragonfly, itu artinya naga terbang. Jadi naganya itu sedang terbang. Okay, sedangkan kalau dragonfly yang dikombine like this, it means we are talking about serangga ini, yaitu okay, capung. Benar sekali. Nah, mungkin adik-adik ada yang takut dengan capung di sini? Alright? No, yeah, of course not. If you're not hurting animal, the animals also wouldn't hurt us. Okay? So, respect each other. Alright? Very great. It's dragonfly. It is a dragonfly. The color of the dragonfly is green. Bisa juga seperti itu. Dragonfly has wings. Ya, jadi dragonfly has wings. Dia memiliki sayap. Benar sekali. Okay. How if you're afraid? You could just say, I am afraid of dragonfly. That's it. That's the example. Okay? Alright. Now we are still talking about the, you know, bugs. Now, what is it? What is the name of this bug? Kira-kira. Alright, to be specific, yeah, the name of this bug is ladybug. Okay, ladybug. Dan penulisannya itu disatukan. So, it's gonna be ladybug. Or, dalam bahasa Indonesia, dia disebut dengan kumbang koksi. Alright, kumbang koksi. There you go. In English, we call this as ladybug. Okay, yang biasanya di badannya itu ada pattern ya, ada pattern ataupun motifnya, coraknya, yaitu bulat-bulat, okay, or the circles. Okay, so if you see this kind of animals, it means serangga ini adalah ladybug. Okay, very great. And then, how to say if you're afraid? I am afraid of ladybug. Atau bisa juga dengan I'm not afraid of ladybug. Ladybug is very cute. Bisa juga. Ladybug is very cute. Artinya ladybug ini ataupun kumbang koksi ini sangat lucu. Seperti itu pemirsa. Get it? Very great. Now, moving on to the next part again. Alright. What is the name of this thing? Dia ini sebenarnya serangga, tapi merupakan hama ya. Oke, okay, sejenis hama ataupun hewan yang mengganggu tanaman. Right, so it's very dangerous if our plants has this on it. Oke, okay? Karena dia akan okay, membuat tanaman kita itu layu ataupun tidak sehat, something like that. Right, so we call this as aphids. Aphids, sorry, it's aphids. Do you know what does it mean? Apa yang dimaksud dengan aphids ini? Alright. Okay, you're certain about the answer? Very nice then. We are going to find out together. Benar sekali. Nah, kalau misalnya yang dimaksud dengan aphids ini adalah kutu daun. Nah, jadi kalau misalnya kutu daun itu ada nggak bahasa Inggrisnya? Tentu saja ada ya pemirsa. Bahasa Inggrisnya itu adalah this one. Okay, now let's learn. Okay, let's Spell it together with me. Okay, very nice. It's gonna be A B H I D S. A B H I D S. Okay, that's it about the box that we're going to learn. We are going to continue soon setelah jeda pariwara. So please stay tuned on TVRI Bengkulu. Don't go anywhere.
Abang suka makan apa? Bang, makan dulu yuk. Katanya mau ikut latihan basket.
Sebentar.
Alpian, ayo latihan. Kita udah kumpul semua nih.
Nanti aja dulu.
Bang, badan Ade panas. Ke apotek sebentar ya, beliin obat.
Sebentar.
Bang.
Gini masih pakai TV analog.
Pakai digital.
Hah? Digital.
Nah, gimana? Bagus kan gambarnya?
Oh. Jadi ini digital.
Halo semuanya, aku Modi, maskot TV digital Indonesia. Aku akan membantu semua orang menuju migrasi TV digital. Di mana? Di siarandigital.id dan call center 159. Ayo semuanya, dukung migrasi TV digital. Bersih gambarnya, jernih suaranya, dan canggih teknologinya.
Pemirsa, selamat bergabung kembali di TVRI Bengkulu dalam acara Forum Edukasi Bahasaku Belajar Bahasa Inggris TVRI Bengkulu. So for those who just joined us, I would like to remind you that the topic for today is going to be about bugs and birds. But now we are still talking about the bugs. So before we already talk about aphids, which means kutu daun. Now we are moving on to the next one, yaitu serangga selanjutnya. Okay, now I would like you guys to pay attention carefully to this thing, yeah? Okay, to this bug ataupun serangga jenis ini. So, okay, sama, mereka ini sama-sama hama. Okay, and it also has similarity to the previous one. But we call this as flea. Okay, in English, which means, artinya itu adalah kutu. Nah, kalau misalnya kutu ini adalah yang sering hinggap di the hair or something like that. Okay, got it? Or whether in your pets, okay? On your pets, I mean, or on your body as well. Okay, on your hair to be specific. Okay, so this one is flea. And flea, it's not a bird, but flea is bug, yeah? Is a bug, ataupun sejenis serangga. Okay, very great. And of course, this animal is quite dangerous, if I could say. Because it also could make you feel itchy ataupun you know, kind of like that. And as well as it will suck your blood the same as mosquito did, okay, for destin. Mm-hmm. So it brings, you know, it destroys, not destroys, but it brings several, you know, bad things to yourself or probably to your this one, okay, plant. So be careful to this two. Now we are moving on to the next one. Okay, this one, okay, doesn't bring the harmfulness to our, you know, our environment as well as ourselves, to be specific. Tapi bisa juga, okay, karena dia ini, you know, hinggapnya di daun-daun. And you know what? Sometimes it, you what is that? It sounds like it may a little bit bothering you. The sounds of this bug may a little bit bothering you. We call this animal ataupun serangga ini sebagai cricket in English. Yep. In English we say this as cricket. Okay, jadi cara pengucapannya itu adalah cricket. Okay, very nice. Repeat after me one more time. It's gonna be cricket. Alright, there you go. Now let's learn, not learn, let's spell it together with me. Can we? Okay, of course we can, yeah. It's gonna be C-R-I-C-K-E-T. Okay, C-R-I-C-K-E-T. Cricket. Okay, that's it. It's a cricket. So, do you know apa itu cricket? Yep, cricket here means jangkrik. Okay, so in bahasa we call this as jangkrik. In English we call this as cricket. Very nice. Now moving on to the next one. Okay, it still, yeah, belongs to bug and not birds. So what does it mean? Okay. All right, I'm sorry, but what is the name of this creature, I mean? Mm-hmm. Ada yang bisa menebak? Yep, we could say this as beetle. Okay, beetle. All right. Please repeat after me one more time. Kita ulangi sekali lagi, yaitu beetle. Beetle. Yep, very nice. Yang artinya itu bisa disebut dengan kumbang tanduk. Okay, there you go. It's beetle. And of course, yeah, beetle belongs to bugs. Yeah, dia ini termasuk jenis serangga. That's it. Okay. How to say if you're afraid of this? Mm-hmm. You could say this one as I'm afraid of beetle. I am afraid of beetle. Okay, very nice. So, moving on to the next one. Moving on to the next one. This is also belongs to bugs, ya, ataupun insects. Yaitu dia ini termasuk jenis serangga. Dan biasanya banyak yang takut akan serangga ini. Alright, there you go. We call this as, in English, as this one. Centipede. Centipede, I'm sorry. The way you pronounce is as centipede. Okay, very nice. Repeat after me one more time. The way to say this as centipede. Very great. Yang artinya itu, kalau di dalam bahasa Indonesia adalah kaki seribu ataupun lipan, ya. Okay, that's it, of course, ya. If you're afraid of this, as it could sting you, you could say this as I am afraid of centipede. Okay, centipede. I am afraid of centipede. Very nice. Okay, there you go again. Centipede. Yep, that's how you pronounce it. Now, let's learn to spell it together with me. It's gonna be C-E-N-T-I, P-E-D-E, alright? It's gonna be C-E-N-T-I-P-E-D-E, centipede. Very clever, very great, ya. If you are afraid, how to express it? Bagaimana tadi adik-adik cara mengungkapkan kalau kalian itu takut? Iya, benar sekali. You could say this, I am afraid of centipede. I am afraid of centipede. Kalau misalnya tidak takut, tinggal ditambahkan not saja. Jadi, I am not afraid of centipede. That's it. Okay? Very great. Very nice. Now, moving on to the next one. Okay, this also still belongs to Benar sekali, masih termasuk ke dalam kategori serangga ataupun bugs, yaitu firefly. Oke, firefly, kalau dia banyak jadi fireflies. Nah, kira-kira apa yang dimaksud dengan firefly? Iya, benar sekali pemirsa. Firefly here means kunang-kunang ya. Jadi hewan kunang-kunang. Oke, that's it. And of course ya, dia ini bisa bercahaya di tengah-tengah, you know, dark circumstances, a dark environment. Jadi ini bisa mengeluarkan cahaya. Back then, people often, you know, use this before the technology as you know, something like as a fire. No, I mean like as a torch, ya. Yeah? Jadi kunang-kunang ini dimasukkan ke dalam like a barrel or something like that, and then they use it in order to light the way or something like that. Okay, got it? Very good. So those are the things that is related to bugs. Jadi itulah tadi beberapa serangga-serangga yang telah kita pelajari. Now we are moving on to the next one, yaitu mengenai birds. Of course, if you're talking about birds, there's also specific name or specific way to say this birds, okay, in English. For example, there you go. Have you ever seen this bird before? Okay, pemirsa pernah ada yang melihat this bird before? Maybe on the television or probably, you know, directly, okay, in the, you know, something like that. All right, in the zoo probably, no? Or yes, just like on the television at least. Okay, this one, we know this as ostrich. Right, so you could say this animal or this bird as ostrich, yang berarti burung unta. Okay, bukan unta ya, tapi this one is burung unta, ostrich. Alright, so that's how you pronounce it, ostrich. Yep, now let's learn how to spell it together with me. It's gonna be O-S-T-R-I-C-H. O-S-T-R-I-C-H. Ostrich. Okay, very nice. I am afraid of ostrich because it has a big size. Like, it's a very big animal or something like that. Bisa juga seperti itu. Okay, that could be an example. Get it? Very nice. Now, before we move on, let's pronounce it again, one more time. Ostrich. It is an ostrich. Very nice. Now, the next bird that we are going to learn today. Of course, ya, kalau misalnya kita berbicara mengenai generalnya, atau secara umum, ini adalah bird. But do you know what kind of birds is it? It is, I'm sorry. Yep, benar sekali. In English, we know this as sparrow. Okay, sparrow. That's how you pronounce it. Sparrow. Alright. Or, di dalam bahasa Indonesia dikenal dengan istilah burung gereja. Okay, because we could see this bird, okay, many of these birds is actually in the church here. So that's why we say this as burung gereja or something like that. In English, we know this as sparrow. Okay, sparrow. It's gonna be like S-P-A-R-R-A-O-W. S-P-A-R-R-O-W. Bisa juga seperti itu, pemirsa. Sparrow. Okay, now moving on to the next one. Okay, this is, okay, sometimes people say this as the strongest bird. Yeah, this is also one of the strongest bird that we know as eagle. Okay, eagle or falcon, something like that, or hawk. So, di dalam bahasa Indonesia artinya ini adalah burung elang. Okay, very clever. So we have ostrich already, we have sparrow, and now we have eagle. Okay, that's it. Eagle, E-A-G-L-E. E-A-G-L-E here, we pronounce it as eagle, dan artinya adalah elang. Very clever. Now, ready to move on to the next one? All right. Have you ever seen this one before, this animal? It could imitate our, you know, not sounds. Yes, our sounds, like the thing that we speak, okay, the thing that we speak, it could imitate our voice, or not our voice, but the thing that we are uttered. Jadi dia ini bisa, you know, kayak mengopi ya, okay, or something like that. Alright, that's it. Okay, we call this as parrot. Sorry, we could say this as parrot. Very nice. It's going to be P-A-R-R-O-T, parrot. Atau dikenal dengan istilah burung beo. Iya, benar sekali pemirsa. So we have also parrot, not carrot, okay? Carrot means wortel, sedangkan this one is parrot. See, even one alphabet could have different meaning in English. So that's why we need to pay attention to it. Okay everyone, before we move on to the next things, kita akan saksikan dulu jeda pariwara. So don't go anywhere, stay tuned on TVRI Bengkulu.
Hai hai pemirsa, jumpa lagi dalam Tahukah Anda. Kali ini kami akan mengajak Anda berkunjung ke Bengkulu untuk mengetahui jejak sejarah Bung Karno. Kota Bengkulu tidak terlepas dari nama besar sang proklamator kemerdekaan dan presiden RI pertama, Soekarno. Setelah keluar masuk penjara dan diasingkan ke ND akibat kegiatan politiknya, Bung Karno dipindahkan ke Bengkulu bersama istrinya Inggit Garnasi dan dua anak angkat mereka. Bung Karno menghabiskan waktu di Bengkulu selama 4 tahun, dari tahun 1938 hingga 1942. Disinilah semangat perjuangan Bung Karno akhirnya bangkit kembali. Tahukah Anda, di Bengkulu pula Bung Karno bertemu Fatmawati yang kemudian menjadi istri Bung Karno yang ketiga. Fatmawati mendampingi Bung Karno melewati masa-masa pendudukan Jepang di Jakarta ketika Indonesia merdeka. Dan kemudian Bung Karno menjadi presiden RI yang pertama didampingi Fatmawati sebagai ibu negara. Fatmawati adalah orang yang menjahit bendera pusaka yang dikibarkan untuk pertama kalinya saat upacara kemerdekaan RI yang pertama. Kepada para pemuda di Bengkulu, Bung Karno mengobarkan semangat nasionalisme. Sudah dulu ya pemirsa, semoga informasi tadi bermanfaat dan menambah wawasan Anda. Sampai jumpa di tayangan Tahukah Anda berikutnya. Salam!
Welcome back to Forum Edukasi Bahasaku, Belajar Bahasa Inggris TVRI Bengkulu. And we already on our last session for today's segment with the title or the topic, birds and bugs. We already talk about bugs, now we are moving on to the kinds of birds. And we did talk about several birds before. Now we are moving on to the next one. This is also, okay, famous for being a nocturnal animals. Jadi dia ini kalau misalnya malam, okay, dia bangun, tapi kalau misalnya pada siang hari dia tidur. So we call this as nocturnal, right? And the name of this animal is owl. Okay, owl, not all, but owl. Owl, yes, very great. Yang artinya adalah burung hantu. Okay, very great. It only consists three alphabets, ya, yaitu O, W, and L. O, W, and L. Owl. Yeah, very clever. So if you would like to see the owl like wake up, okay, if you would like to see the owl is waking up, you could see them on the night, yeah, instead of on the day, okay, instead of, you know, during the daylight or something like that. Because kalau misalnya pada siang hari dia tadi sleeping, benar sekali. All right, now moving on to the next one. Okay, so yes, of course, yeah, this is a penguin. Penguin, and a penguin belongs to birds. Ya, jadi penguin ini juga, ataupun penguin ini termasuk ke dalam kategori birds ya pemirsa. And of course ya, dia ini live okay, in the, you know, cold environment. Di, you know, what was that environment ataupun lingkungan yang dingin, something like that. Therefore, if you see this animal on the zoo, usually perawatannya pun akan lebih ekstra ya, karena seperti kita ketahui negara kita ini adalah negara tropis, sedangkan mereka terbiasa hidup di tempat yang dingin seperti kutub utara or something like that dan selatan. Okay, get it? Very clever. Now moving on to the next one. This is also kind of birds. It may look a little bit similar to the ostrich, okay, on the picture, but it's not ostrich. Kalau ostrich tadi ya, dia itu besar, okay, and it, you know, the wings, it's also not like this, right? This one, we know this as vulture, okay? We know this as vulture. So the way you pronounce this animal as vulture, okay? Benar sekali, bukan vulture ya, adik-adik, mainkan vulture. This bird, it's vulture, yang berarti adalah burung bangkai ataupun haring ya, okay, I'm sorry. It's haring ataupun burung bangkai, okay? But in English, we call this as vulture. Vulture, V-U-L-T-U-R-E, vulture. Very clever. So have you ever seen this kind of birds before? Not yet? Okay, you could see this on the television or on other platforms. If you are curious, yeah, later on, you could check it out. Now, moving on to the next one. This is also kind of birds that we need to know. And the name of this bird, okay, is hummingbird. Jadi ditulis satu ya, hummingbird, digabung. So what does it mean by hummingbird here? Ada yang tahu? Yap, benar sekali. Hummingbird here means burung, kolibri. Okay, benar. So hummingbird ini also could, you know, not like people often say they could sing, yeah, okay, because they have like a very good voice or something like that. So it's hummingbird, hummingbird. Okay, there you go. Benar sekali. Kalau misalnya kalian takut, bagaimana tadi? I am afraid of hummingbird. Iya, benar sekali pemirsa. Now can we move to the next one? Okay, this is also kind of another kind of bird that we need to know today. So, have you ever seen this? Atau mungkin ada yang tahu pemirsa yang ada di rumah? Iya, benar sekali. So this one is famous for being woodpecker. Woodpecker. So what does it mean by woodpecker here? Iya, benar sekali. Dia ini adalah burung pelatuk. Okay, so woodpecker in English and bahasa Indonesianya adalah ini. Okay, get it everyone? Very clever. Now please repeat after me one more time the way you say this as woodpecker. W-O-O-D-P-E-C-K-E-R. Woodpecker. Very clever. Now moving on to the next one. Alright. This one ya, kalau ini kayaknya pemirsa yang ada di rumah sudah familiar to this kind of animal ataupun bird. Yep, benar sekali. We know this as pigeon. Okay, pigeon here yang berarti adalah burung merpati. Yep, benar sekali. And back then, pigeon has the role to deliver, you know, to deliver the message or something like that to the letter, to deliver the letter as well. Ya, jadi kalau dulu ini, before there is a technology like nowadays, pigeon ini digunakan sebagai kayak alat komunikasi juga ya. Okay, for example, the pigeon could bring the letter ataupun surat or something like that. But now not anymore atau sangat jarang ya, something like that, because we already have the technology. Now, the next one, this is also belongs to bird. Okay, it may seem similar to the name of the country, but in this context, it's not a country. The turkey here, okay, means kalkun. Okay, so turkey itu juga belongs to birds category. Atau dia termasuk juga ke dalam kategori burung ya pemirsa, or something like that. So it's like turkey. Alright, T-U-R-K-E-Y. K-E-Y, Turkey. Very clever. And in Western country, Turkey is also very famous for being some things that we need to, you know, cook during the Thanksgiving or something like that. Okay, now moving on to the next one. Nah, kalau ini sepertinya kita sangat familiar ya, because we familiar to this kind of birds, yaitu quail. Okay, in English we call this as quail. Okay, very nice. Sedangkan kalau misalnya di dalam bahasa Indonesia, kita mengenalnya atau lebih dikenal dengan istilah burung puyuh. Nah, apakah burung puyuh memiliki bahasa Inggris atau term Inggrisnya, English terms? Of course, ya. Yeah. Now, you know the English terms for this adalah quail. Q-U-A-I-L, quail. Okay, jadi kalau misalnya telur puyuh, itu adalah quail egg. Okay, get it? Very clever. Can you guess the next birds that we are going to learn? Okay. There you go. It has a very beautiful feather, ya. Dia memiliki bulu yang sangat beautiful. Okay. And it could be like this, blooming like that. Ataupun bisa mekar seperti itu. Now, can you guess it? Or have you ever seen this before? Have you ever meet this kind of bird directly? Or maybe see this through the television? Iya, benar sekali pemirsa. The name of this bird is peacock. Okay, the way you pronounce it as peacock. Yap, yang artinya adalah burung merak. Okay, so we have so many birds to be learned today. Next one, okay. This one. This, you know, ada kepercayaan yang menyatakan bahwa this bird has the role in delivering the not good information, or it may like a sign to be a bad luck or something like that. So can you guess the name of this animal atau this bird? Mm-hmm, to be specific, yep, this one is crow. Okay, crow, C-R-O-W. Atau di dalam bahasa Indonesia dikenal dengan istilah burung gagak. Iya, benar sekali ya. Gagak in bahasa, meanwhile in English we call that as crow. C-R-O-W. And people, there are several people that believes that actually the crow brings the news, bring the not so good news. Okay, it's like a sign. Okay, if there is a crow suddenly in your house, there must be something happen. But we don't know, right? It's only a belief. Yeah, you could believe it or not. That's it. The point. All right. Okay. So we already learned about so many bugs as well as birds today. Yeah. But unfortunately, ya pemirsa, it's been an hour already. Sudah 1 jam. Saya Sri Rahayu Putri dan seluruh kru yang bertugas menemani Anda. Akhir kata kami harus pamit undur diri. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to wash your hand and keep yourself being healthy as well. Ya. Yeah? Sampai ketemu di episode selanjutnya. Thank you very much and have a great life, everyone. Bye-bye. See you on the next episode.